Hello guys, and welcome to this video tutorial from Biology Slideshow. In this video we will talk about native PAGE, which stands for native polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis. So in this technique our objective is to maintain the 3D structure of protein and also maintain the functionality. So in this case we don't use any denaturing agent like SDS, and also we don't use any reducing agent. In this case the proteins will be separated as original proteins in any sieving gel based on their charge, size and shape. As we talked earlier in SDS PAGE technique, also native PAGE uses discontinuous gel. That means that we have two phases of the gel. One is called resolving gel, which is higher in acrylamide concentration and also more alkaline and occupies the majority of the gel chamber. And the second one is a stacking gel. Samples move through the stacking gel and then across the resolving gel. And resolving gel, which is higher in acrylamide concentration, is much better for band separation. This property is known as band sharpening. So what is the difference between SDS PAGE and native PAGE? Basically in SDS PAGE we have two forms, non-reducing SDS PAGE and reducing SDS PAGE. So in case of non-reducing SDS PAGE, let's assume that we have this protein which has two polypeptide chains that are linked together through two disulfide bonds, and in this case we use SDS as denaturing agent, and we got those two chains are negatively charged, stratified but not totally separated because of existence of disulfide bonds. But in case of reducing agent, we use both of denaturing agent and also reducing agent as beta-murakkabtoethanol in this case. And we will get the two polypeptide chains are totally separated and negatively charged because beta-murakkabtoethanol can reduce the disulfide bonds. In case of native PAGE, we don't use any of this, so we maintain the 3D structure of the protein. So the mechanism of separation in native PAGE is similar to that in case of SDS PAGE. You might refer to that video for better understanding, and I will leave a link in the description of this video. So mainly we have three molecules. First of all, the chloride ion, which is negatively charged and that the fastest in movement, and the next one is the glycine, which is the simplest amino acid because the stacking gel is a little bit acidic, and the protein or protein complex will be stacked in between. But once those molecules reach the resolving gel, chloride ion will be the fastest one, followed by glycine, which will become much more faster because the alkaline environment of the resolving gel, the protein will be left behind. But there are different factors that are contributing in the separation of proteins in case of native PAGE. So those are the charge, size and shape. So in case of charge, we have this concept which is charge density, which means how positive the charge or how negative the charge along the length of the protein. As you might remember, in case of SDS PAGE, we use SDS that provide the same mass to charge ratio for all proteins. So they have the same charge density. But in case of native PAGE, we might have different proteins with the same mass but also different charges. The majority of proteins have isoelectric point between 3 and 8. So they can move towards the positive pole. In case of proteins that have isoelectric point higher than 8 or 9, we might reverse the anode and cathode. In this case, the electrophoresis will be conducted towards the negative pole. So the proteins are generally moved from the negative pole towards the positive pole. And let's assume that we have two proteins. One is highly negatively charged and the other one is more neutral. So the protein which holds more negative charge is the fastest to move towards the positive pole. And the protein which is more neutral will be slower. The other factor is shape and size. We can express shape and size by resistance of the sieving porous gel to move. This is also known as frictional force. So how this gel resists the movement of those proteins when the electric field is applied. So this is reflect the 3D structure or the 3D shape of the protein. So as you might expect, that small protein might penetrate or move faster towards the positive pole. Unlike the proteins that's much larger or huger in size, more complicated shape, they will move more slower through the sieving porous gel. In this case, if we have two proteins, one is more globular, its movement through the gel will be much harder than fibrous protein. So as we talked earlier, in case of non-reducing SDS page, we get a negatively charged and stratified and linked two polypeptide chains, A and B. This will be represented by one band. In case of reducing SDS page, those chains will be separated and will be represented by two different bands in the gel. Those bands have lighter weight and hence they move much more faster in the gel compared to the non-reducing form. But in case of native page, nothing will be changed. We maintain the whole 3D structure of the protein. So this is will appear in one band, and please notice that this band is in different position from the non-reducing SDS page form because there are different factors that affecting the movement. We have also here the size, shape and shape and the charge density also. So the application of native page is mainly to understand the structure of a protein more clearly. We might study the hydrophobic and hydrophilic properties of the protein. Also, by maintaining the 3D structure of a protein, we maintain its functionality. So this is can be used to understand the protein-protein interactions and protein-DNA interactions. Also, this will help us to identify and purify the active form of proteins. In most cases, we isolate enzymes and study the activity of enzymes by using this method. We also may quantify the proteins. So that was everything about native page. If you have any question related to the topic, type a comment and I will try to provide the answer as soon as I can. Please hit the like button and